Whew. Hi, everybody. We are back. And you know what? We are back this time with much resolve, because that's right. It's time to go explore a cave. I did my mental preparations. And normally, I'm not really one to explore a cave or have a fun time exploring a cave. But I have a good feeling about this. You know what I think is going to happen? You know what I think is going to be at the end of all of this? Can we actually go into the middle there? I don't know why we'd want to do that. Explore the cave. Now, where is this cave? It was like down here somewhere. Is the cave? Cave 452. Okay, so we need to head north. Which way is north? Now we have this like awesome... Okay, it's like this way. All right, so we need to find a path to the north. And that's going to take us to the cave. All right, cool. So what I think is going to happen when we go into the cave, all right, this is my new working theory, okay? I'm no longer stuck on bears, although there could be a bear in there, having thought about it a little bit, actually. Am I going the right way here? I don't believe I am, somehow. I need to be heading, like, this way. I don't think that there is going to be bear down there, though. I think that that would be too easy. I think that this game is leading up to... coming back to where it began, okay? So Julia, you know, having onset dementia at a young age or whatever. Henry sort of having an episode in the middle of the forest here where he thinks he got a phone call from Julia, which is quite possible, actually. And a bunch of other things. Holy fuck, I have gone the wrong way. I cannot believe it. Okay, we need to, like, find a north path here. So there should be, like, a path that leads up this way somewhere. Supply cache. Is this the north? Yeah, this is the north. Okay. We're going to get back on track. So the new working theory is that this is... Henry has lost his mind. And actually, the guy with the flashlight and doing a bunch of weird shit out here and being creepy and stalking these girls. Fuck, how have I managed to do this? Does anyone even know? I mean, I'm the worst. I'm too busy talking. This view. Too busy talking to actually pay attention to where I'm going. I'm trying to make it to this cave, but I'm like hopelessly lost. Henry has been being creepy out here. He's been doing stuff with a flashlight to people, possibly flashing more than just his light at people. And he's the one with the dementia, and this is a story about Henry's dementia. This is my working theory. This is what I think is going to be the case. Fuck me. How do I get to this cave? How do I get to this path? Where is this path? I've like overshot it again. I'm trying to get up to this Thunder Canyon path so that I can get onto that creek, but I keep missing it. It's definitely to the north. There's definitely, like, a path to the north. Sorry about this. We will definitely figure this out, though, and we will get there. So this is the way we kind of want to go, and there should be a path around here somewhere that takes us that way. Like, through here! No wonder! Okay, now we can actually clear this block trail, okay. It was a little bit of a hidden one. Alright, so, Delilah is quite possibly, because you never see her, just a figment of his imagination, okay? We're going to go into a cave, and we're probably going to see Julia in the cave, okay? I'm just warning you, this is what I think is going to happen, and maybe some scientists. And the scientists are going to probably be doctors, because I think that Henry is not even out here right now physically. I think that he is probably, like, in some sort of care home or something, as being looked after by people, and that maybe is why he's sort of saying, like, you know, people are following his moves, and it's all about him and stuff like that. This is what I think, anyway. But we never know. Who knows? We'll see. Okay. It's, like, up this way, isn't it? Is this the right way? Yeah, we kind of have to go up, then down, and around. Okay. I've, like, taken the longest possible way here for some reason. But anyway. It's given me some time to explain where I'm coming from with my line of thinking. Maybe... that's not right, okay? Maybe it is just a very straightforward story of real life, and he's out here for the reason that Julia had dementia and gone away and stuff like that. But I don't believe it, okay? I think there's going to be more to it than that. And I think it's going to turn out that it's going to be like, basically like Super Mario Brothers 2. You remember in Super Mario Brothers 2, you get to the end of it. I don't want to spoil Super Mario Brothers 2 for you if you've never played it before, but in the end, it was all a dream. And, you know, some stories are like that, I guess. It doesn't make them, like, you know, bad stories or whatever. I mean, this story has been awesome so far, actually. It's been really, really good. So I'm looking forward to see how it ends either way, whether it's bad or good. But I just think that there is going to be more to it. Than just like a straightforward like,
hey, you know, it's Ned. I've been following you the whole time because I was annoyed that my son lost his backpack or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
All right, we rappel down here and we are very close to the entrance of the cave. It is a very smoky day out here in the wilderness. And that's probably thanks to two massive fires. It's probably more fires than Delilah's ever seen in her 13 years of service, right? Okay, so we need to head south, which is this way. I would not have gone this way, but this is the way that we need to go. And we're gonna, it's gonna lead us right to the cave entrance, which is like just around here. Okay. All right, everybody ready? Is everybody ready for the grand finale? I made it. Hey, is this being closed and locked again? Or did I close this one myself? Why is there a fucking horn in here? Does anyone remember? Yeah, anyway. All right, here's the cave. We have the key for the cave. We actually do have a flashlight now, too, that we can use. All right, I've made it. Ho! Oh, hang on to your butts. This is going to be crazy. We just shoved the gate. All right, who's in here? Maybe it's like a bunker or something.
What the hell?
What the hell what? Did it just close?
That's pretty fucking creepy. Jesus, this is a big cave.
It's a long, steep drop. What is that? It's like some sort of find a way out of the cave. Okay. We're going to use the Pulaski on these loose rocks to cause some sort of like cave in or something. Shafts of light. Okay, let's squeeze through here. There's no going back. After you squeeze through. Oh shit, maybe we're going to be buried alive. Oh, that would be something. Holy crap, that would scare the shit out of me. Like, imagine like getting caught in an avalanche or something. That would be even spookier.
Freezing in here.
It's really cold in this cave. It's really cold. Maybe they're taking me down to like the operation theater. Maybe this is like, you know, coming back to like my working theory. Maybe I'm gonna be operated on. Maybe it's aliens. Maybe there is a bear in here after all. Fuck, who knows? Maybe we're gonna hop over here and, hello Henry, it's the clown. The whole clown, shit, I'm stuck. No, I didn't wanna go back down this way, come on. No, so close to the end, I think. Hello? Oh, here we go. What could it be? Hey, it's a way out. And there's a long drop down. Hey, it's the communication lives. Hi, I was trapped in a cave.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
Yeah, somebody closed the door on me.
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away.
Yeah.
I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus.
I might have been stuck in there, Dilla.
No. No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
Oh, maybe that was it.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
Don't push me,
Ned. I just have my ropes. Okay. I'm going to hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Oh.
That doesn't sound dangerous.
Goodness sake. Maybe I ran through the cave too fast and didn't notice like all the stuff that I was supposed to notice, possibly. Oh. Hey, I found a hideout.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Yeah, I found his little...
He built himself a real castle.
He's got a whole bunch of dinosaurs and stuff out here, too. Look at this one. Ooh, maybe he's still out here. It's a hand... The Goodwins, family crest. It's a handmade sign.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
Yeah.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe what? He made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah.
Hey, what's this?
Sorry. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, so maybe he didn't
sure
die.
It was quite elaborate.
It's
our camera.
Some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
It is kind of weird.
Maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Oh.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Okay, I found his school folder, too. Smarter than me? Are you saying I'm a knucklehead?
You're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge.
All right, you ready?
All these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
All right.
That wait's over, sweetheart.
I'm going to drop some big knowledge bombs on you right now.
You'll use that big sexy brain of yours to fill out your unemployment paperwork.
Sorry, boss.
Wow. She means business.
I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
He was a doodler. Oh, my God. Looks like he was really into the NBA.
You're dead. The Draculords. Brian Goodwin.
Nice. Do we want to keep some of this stuff? I guess we probably do, actually, right? I'm, like, chucking it all on the ground, but we should probably keep it. Oh, you know what? Is this a seat cushion? Yeah, it is. There's a banner. Do we want to keep it? Do we want to keep picking up banners? Look, maybe there's something underneath all of these banners. Can we chuck them all away? Okay, there's nothing underneath all these banners. 5 degrees north and... Oh, there's a comic
book. He'd
hide
out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he... honors them with a black armband, which gives him superpowers.
Cool.
That's fucking dark.
Whoa. I found a whole bunch more stuff, Delilah, underneath the banner. That's right. There's a Wizards and Wyverns sheet. There's a note to a ranger. There's a ham radio diagram. There's a Game Boy and a postcard as well. Let's take the note to the ranger, shall we?
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was going to hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. I mean, it sounds like Ned was pushing him and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
Oh.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
And now he's out here. Fucking with me as well.
There's some grade A nerdy document here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half elf, armor 7.
Studded leather.
Classic Wizards and Wyverns.
How do you know Delilah? Delilah's in on this still. There's a bundle of pitons. Is that like, what are these things? Oh, of course, they're like climbing gear. There's the ham radio diagram.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him, you know, tinkering on stuff like that.
Oh my God, it is Ned, isn't it? It's all Ned. Okay, we want to report this to you.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, really.
That doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
I wonder if this thing still works, actually. It looks smashed.
There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
The fuck,
Brian
Delilah?
Had everything he loved out there.
Pooh. There's a loose stone here. Should I pick it up? There's something under it. Oh my God. It's Brian's fingernail. No, somebody was out here peeling off his fingernails. I think I've gotten everything here. There's another banner here. Wall. It's like something on the back of this. No, just drop that. Alright, well, Fort Goodwin has been ransacked. We've completely and utterly ransacked all of this. There's a lot of ropes and stuff here. I guess he was setting up to build a fort, but does that mean that maybe it's close by to where they were camping out or whatever?
So, like, something I never told you, or about Brian.
Yeah.
In regards to him being out here, you know, being against the rules. They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied, and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Well, how do you know, though? Maybe he's dead. Maybe she knows he's dead. Maybe she killed him. Maybe she's eating him right now. Maybe she's actually eating one of his fingers right now. Just crunching away on one of those fingers.
Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill him. Nobody did.
Oh, nice.
Some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and landed in jail.
Why do they have so much fun?
I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever happened at their camp.
I think we'd be smart to let sleeping dogs lie.
Why are they having so much goddamn fun all the time? Joyriding on a tractor, taking all their clothes off and swimming in a lake? Like, the fun never stops with those two. Did we want to try to actually go back around? What are we meant to be doing now? Explore deeper into the cave. Oh yeah, that's right. We got our little piton things, right? So we need to actually anchor them into the thing. Unless somebody's standing here now. No? They locked the door again? They actually locked me in. I can't believe it. And now we're going back in. Okay, let me guess. It's gonna close again. Come on! No? Okay. Gonna wait for us to go deeper into the cave, I guess. Oh no, they gave up this time. Alright, we're putting our piton into the crack. And we're going to rappel down deep into the cave. What could possibly be down here? Imagine we found... You know I was saying, like, how crazy it would be if we found a clown? What if we found, like, a pile of bones with a clown costume on top of it? Like, a dead clown. That'd be fucked up. I'm up for that, though. I'm not too worried, because I still think that this is just all, like, in fucking Henry's mind, right? Like, I don't think that any of this is for real. Okay, we're gonna drop down. We're going deep inside a cave. There's either going to be, like, a meth lab down here or... Oh, man, maybe, like, the fucking cartel is going to be down here. They're going to be, hey, Henry, what you doing down here, man? And then they're just going to, like, douse him in gasoline. Shit. I found a dead body. It's Brian.
Are you... Oh, God.
I found a dead body down here. Hello, it's Brian Goodwin. Oh, shit. Brian Goodwin fell down here. Oh, are we gonna step down? Broken.
Poor fucking kid.
Damn it. That's a steep shaft. Okay, we're gonna step over him very carefully. Poor guy. Fuck, he's been down here a while. Well, like 3 years, I guess? Alright. So, does that mean that... Okay. I guess we can't radio from in here. Climb out of cave and report body. Okay, I'm trying to. I would like to run, actually. There, okay. We can finally run again. Alright, we're going to run out of cave and report body of Brian. But there may be some more stuff down here. Fucking poor Brian. So he did die. Maybe Ned... just, like, couldn't find him and didn't bother reporting him missing? I mean, that's kind of fucked up. Or are we going to find Ned's dead body as well? Or did Ned shoot himself or something? Christ knows. Who's at the top? Hello? Big jump scare? No? I'm kind of ready right now, actually. I'm ready for any sort of jump scare this game could throw at me. Unless, of course, it's a clown. I'm not ready for a clown. Okay. We're going to drop down. I fucking hate all these, like, blocks that you have to climb up on and stuff. Just, like... Oh, God. Okay. We need to drop down here, too. Alright, I think we're, like, almost out of the cave. Oh, what's down here? Ah, look. It's the entrance. We come down and around? Nobody closed the door this time. Hey, what was that? You see that? It's crazy. Alright. Let's climb up here. And then we can get onto the radio and tell Delilah that Brian Poor Brian has died.
Hey, D.
There you are. Bad news for you. I've been worrying my ass off.
Well, I have some, I'm sorry, D.
Hey, I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
About what? You're freaking me out.
He's in there.
What are you saying, Henry?
The only thing in the cave is Brian. He's dead. His body is in the cave, Delilah.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
No, it's for real.
What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Made to look like one.
I don't know, maybe it was Ned.
If not him directly, he put enough stupid fucking know-how in his head to get him killed. Son of a bitch.
Fuck, it is, yeah. Ned. Fucking Ned is on the loose still, isn't he?
What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No, I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave.
Well, how'd you know he was rotting?
There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Oh. All right. Well, what about, like, all the fucking monitoring equipment and shit, though? What the hell? Is that my toilet paper? Pack up my belongings. Okay. I mean, I have tons. Where do I even start? Okay. I'll take my hat. Can I put the hat into my stuff? Oh, there's a clipboard here.
You see that plane?
No, I missed it. I was busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Oh, it's really bad.
Is this the flapjack fire or the site fire or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
Do you want to talk about how all this is connected?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck.
Hey, the beeping has started again.
For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
Not again.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay, we're back on it.
Yeah, look, it's time to sleep. Pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look. Okay. If something happens,
I'll remember you.
Oh, thanks, Delilah. Could this be a trap?
I mean, am I walking into a trap right now?
Yeah, yeah.
I hope not. I would much rather remember you from a bar somewhere and not a jail cell. Please find who made that tape.
All right. How do I pack up my belongings? Site reports. Let's take the cassette tape, shall we? Okay. We're going to take the cassette tape. Let's take the report on Delilah, which we can't. Let's take this. Our photo with Julia, okay? So that they know who we are. Let's also take the tracking device, okay? And let's open the desk drawer and take 8 the hard way. And not take that, but let's take this like little pencil that I can't seem to get, and my wedding ring is also in that drawer. I can't get that either. Is there anything else here worth taking? The hat. Let's put on the hat. All right, it's Ned's hat. Okay, let's take this mug. Let's take some toilet paper with us just in case we shit our pants while we're out here. We might actually be doing that. Okay. All right, I think I have everything. Let's put on, or sorry, let's turn off the lights, safety first, and let's find the source of this infernal beeping. All right, beeping. Time to meet your maker. That's right. We want to solve the mystery. That's right. Where's the mystery? Where is it? It's west. It's over here again? No way. No goddamn way. Not on my watch. It's not through the same fucking thicket again, is it? Hey, maybe it's gonna lead me right into the fire, and I'm just gonna run right into the fire and die. What a way to end the game! That would be something, wouldn't it? Oh, it's gotta be the end now. Right? Or wrong? Oh shit, maybe they attached the waveform thing to a bear. Oh shit! No! No, Henry, don't! You don't know what you're doing! Look! Where are you going? You're frolicking around out here in the wilderness. Shut up, Delilah.
I think I'm getting close.
Delilah.
Well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian.
I can hear planes.
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Oh shit, we might actually meet Delilah at long last if you can believe this. Alright, I don't know, actually, I'm not even sure how long this episode is, but I think we're just gonna play it through now and not bother cutting it, because we're kind of getting close to the end, right? We have to be, unless it takes like some crazy ass turn again. Anyway, we're getting close to the beeping. What could it be? Maybe they put like a transponder on Ned's dead body. Maybe Ned's out here too and he's dead. Ned's dead, baby. Oh my lord, no. I found a cassette
Someone
tape.
Left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a
They wrote my name in piss.
Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Uh-oh.
Oh my god, Henry.
What, Delilah? Do you want me to listen to it? All right, I'm going to listen to it.
Yeah,
ready?
Hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up.
I knew it was fucking Ned the whole time.
We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I got to go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it.
All right.
You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for fuck's sake.
Oh, shit. It was Ned.
I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two.
The fuck?
You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way.
Holy
you know,
shit.
I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point.
Wow.
Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
Holy shit. No.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
What the hell?
Ned Goodwin. He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
The fuck?
He's got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
Summer weight gain goal, 35 pounds.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Look at all this shit. Hey, it's the stereo! Hike north to Thorfair Lookout for evacuation. Okay. Look!
This boombox looks familiar.
It's the girl's boombox that I threw in the lake, remember?
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
Why isn't Delilah answering? Electronic junk? Oh look, I found his undies and stuff. It's a list of supplies. You know what? I'm fucking keeping some of this shit. That's right. If anyone ever... Oh, look at that.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site.
Oh, okay. Let's fucking... He's using a typewriter. Research site
everything
info.
He did to us. And everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
Okay, I've got it all. Don't worry. Father's Day card. He...
God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff.
A photo. Oh, look at that. Fucking poor kid. Alright, look it. Oh, fuck, what a creepy asshole. Look at this guy. He's got a lawn chair.
He had quite the view.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well,
man, what's all this
take
radio
a picture
lines?
If you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
Okay, good idea, Delilah. I got a few snaps left on old Brian's camera. Here we go. I'm taking some pictures so that you can see it. Oh, look, he can see your lookout tower, or is that mine? I'm not sure. All right, okay. I got a couple of snaps. I'm making my way back. Holy crap. Maybe I'm gonna die. You think I'm gonna die? Okay, we need to hike north to the evac point, but we're like, fuck me. All right, we got a long way to go and a short time to get there. That's right, we're about to die in a fire. I can't get through here. What's this clothesline doing here? Fuck. And he had a pretty sweet place. He lots of trash. He had a place to chop wood. He had a cool makeshift hatch. And now we have to head this away and evacuate the forest before we die in a fire. We took all of the evidence, so if we ever need anything to prove our innocence, we've got it all. I mean, none of it is really circumstantial or anything either. This is like hard evidence. I don't think there's any denying that Ned is batshit insane and he's living out here in the wild and possibly trying to kill me still. One thing we don't know yet is whether or not he's dressed as a clown. Okay, he could still be dressed as a clown. And you know what? Maybe, just maybe, my theory still holds true. You know, maybe this is still just Henry going, you know, suffering with dementia out here. And he's not even out here. Hike north to thoroughfare lookout for evacuation. Okay, we have a long ass way to go. We have to go, like, up to Jonesy Lake, through Thunder Canyon. Fuck, it's going to take us forever. You know what? It's so far away, I think it's just going to teleport us when we get to a certain point, right? It's got to, right? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, we can't be expected to walk all the way there. Look, we can't even rappel. Come on. It's not actually rappelling when you go up. It's climbing. Fuck me. Look at how long it takes. Maybe Ned's gonna be at the top here. Maybe this is the only way out of here, and Ned's gonna be at the top and he'll be like, I couldn't let you get out of here, Henry. That's why now you're dead. No? Okay. He's not. I mean, he's not here, but there's still possibly the...
I should be relieved.
Remote possibility
relieved
of
that there's no evidence of us starting that fire.
Henry?
Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. It was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Goddamn. I think it was an accident. He wasn't a good dad. I think it actually was an accident.
I think it was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
I know.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry?
Well, now, Brian's dead.
Sorry.
I mean, Ned did push him.
God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
Maybe, don't blame yourself.
You didn't do anything wrong.
She's on the edge.
Yes,
okay.
I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not.
You did
and
do a
do,
couple
I'm
things wrong.
Asked about Ned Goodwin.
Yeah, you are. It's true. I mean, you are in all sorts of trouble, actually.
Oh, fuck.
I'm glad I'm not you.
Yeah,
I hear a helicopter. Oh no, it's Ned.
Hey.
Oh.
No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming.
I'm almost there.
One second.
Can you guys just come and pick me up somewhere?
Here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
No, don't. Wait.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
I'm lost.
Henry, they're here. They're waiting right now.
Come on.
Please.
Just wait.
Henry, I don't...
2 seconds.
I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that.
Why not?
I know that sounds harsh.
Oh, Delilah, come on. You could have waited for
okay,
me.
Okay, I'll wait.
Okay, thanks.
I'm not far.
Okay.
I am far. Delilah, I'm lost. Help me. Send help, Delilah. Please. Get them out here. Oh, shit. Is this a shitter? Wait, is this my shitter? Whose shitter is this? It is my shitter. Fuck me. See what I mean about my awareness in general? It's terrible. All right. So, we want to head north, okay? North to Delilah. That's right. North to Delilah. Dong, digga, dong, 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 dong. That's right, Delilah. I hope she's waiting so that we can actually finally see who she is, if she's even real. I mean, I don't even think she's real at this point. I'm pretty sure she's not. Okay, so we want to keep heading north. We actually have to hike all the way out of here. I can't believe it. I mean, at the same time, though, it's quite nice. It's quite nice to have a nice romantic solo hike out of this place. I mean, this place, it's got to be said, is on fire. So we're kind of like going as fast as we can. Ned, hopefully, if you're out there, please don't try to get in the way of my progress of getting out of here. I'm trying my best out here, Ned. Okay? I'm not going to tell anyone. And actually, I think if you're still listening to the radio and stuff, I said that you were innocent, okay? Oh shit, it's the cave again. Oh no. Ned? Henry! No? Okay, good. Oh, that was creepy. Alright! I think we're almost there. Well, I say we're almost there. I mean, we still have quite a ways to go, but we're on the right track. This is the main thing, right? We're gonna, run as fast as we can. I mean, you know what this reminds me of, actually? Remember the movie Platoon? We're like Elias, aren't we? We're out here running, and, you know, the chopper is waiting for us. And maybe the chopper is about to leave without us, and we're going to be down here with the sad music, dropping onto our knees and holding our arms up in the air, saying, "Why did you guys leave without me?" But maybe that's not going to happen, actually. Oh, I can hear the choppers and the planes. Fuck, this is really crazy, isn't it? Look at it. It's really kind of scary. I mean, this has actually highlighted to me that I never want to be in the middle of a forest fire. Oh. Oh, look. Is the music going, like, all nice now because we're close to the end? Oh. There's the cabin. The old shitter. I thought they were both haunted at one point. Turns out that they're not. Okay. There's the cabin. What way was it again? It was like through here, I think, and then up and around here, but we still want to be heading north as much as we possibly can. We follow these lines, right? They sort of lead up to where we need to go. Okay, we're gonna hop over here. Man, we are gonna be in great shape at the end of all this. Holy crap, like this jog alone. And can you imagine how many calories we're burning right now? Jeez, Delilah's in for a real treat. Once she sets her eyes upon us, we're like a fucking model of a man at this point, I would say. So, is any stone left unturned here? We figured out that it was Ned stalking us and being crazy the whole time. The two girls were indeed not murdered. They were joyriding out there on a tractor somewhere, which was kind of weird, actually. We have to go back down this way. Oh, yes, I remember all this. Oh, yeah, that's right. We have to go back down here because this is like a bit of a dead end. It like loops up into a dead end. I thought we were going the right way. And Brian was pushed to do things that maybe he wasn't so good at and died in a climbing accident, and Ned didn't bother to go down to get his body because of the grief and stuff. And he didn't report it either because he didn't want the hassle and stuff. So he's just been living out here in the wilderness by himself this whole time for the past 3 years, and will continue to do so unless we sort of tell somebody what happened and they come out here and they search for him. I don't know if you guys ever played Fallout New Vegas, and indeed some of the like the DLC for Fallout New Vegas, but remember the, I can't remember the name of the DLC now, it's been a little while, but there was the DLC where you were out in like the Grand Canyon or whatever, and there was like all those caves that you could explore, and there was like a story of a ranger who was like living in those caves, and you happened to cross like his terminals, and it told the story of how he, you know, survived like the blast and just like lived out in these caves and stuff, and it was pretty interesting. This kind of reminds me of that, actually. Maybe Ned is like that ranger, sort of. Oh yeah, shit, okay. Here's the tram. I've been to it many times trying to reach Delilah. Now, finally, I think it's gonna be operational so that we can actually get to Delilah. We had to do this whole track manually, and also my sense of direction is terrible and it took me forever to get here, but I'm glad to be here now, and I'll be glad to see the emergency cable car on this side. Okay, Delilah, I made it. I hope you're still waiting.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there?
She left.
Delilah?
She actually left. I can't believe it. Now we're gonna die on this. Are we? I wonder if we're gonna die on this. She left without me. She doesn't want anything to do with me now that she found out the truth about what happened. Oh, is this hers? Hike to north to Thoroughfare Lookout. Okay. I guess we're there. Okay. Oh, man. Maybe this whole time she wasn't even up here. You know, maybe she's... Oh, look at her shitter. It's in pretty good condition. Betcha it smells nice, too. All right. We've made it.
Oh, God, it's a nightmare out there.
Hello? Are Hello? You up here? It's Delilah. Abandoned, I betcha. Delilah? Ned? Does she have a picture of Teddy Roosevelt? She's got some slippers. It doesn't look like she's packed up much. She's got an apple that she might have been eating. We're not so different, you and I, Henry. What we know, white and shorts. Okay, and with the pencil mustache, of course, and always wearing a tuxedo. Okay, so she does exist. Redneck, grebe, magnificent frigate bird. Osprey and Wood Stork. Stark. Wildland fire danger rating. Radio headset. You left without me, didn't you, Delilah? Fucking,
hello?
I can't believe
it. Is anybody there?
Hello, I'm stranded.
Hi. Yeah, it's me.
Hi, Delilah. Have you left me out here to die?
No. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad.
I'm not.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
I get it.
I get it.
You do?
No.
I think so.
It shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay, great. Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
All right.
Shit.
Hey, I noticed that you're growing some plants here.
We found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented... one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
Oh, I'll think you'll get over it, for Christ's sake.
No, and you'll have to... I don't know.
I hear police sirens.
Yeah.
Are we in trouble?
Me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you.
Okay, Delilah.
All right, sure. Maybe.
Come to Boulder with me. Move to Santa Fe. You'd make a good shrink. Let's ask her to come to Boulder.
Maybe.
See what happens.
You could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there.
No.
Come on, Delilah. Just a thought.
You know you want to.
You don't want me down there.
No, well, you're probably right.
Just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Oh.
Okay. So, what about me?
Jeez. Well, you should probably put that typewriter to good use. Hey, if you ever decide to write about this, I'd really appreciate it if you gave me a sexy accent or something that, you know, would play well in the movie version.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
I'm going to make Delilah into the clown who chases people through the wilderness.
Get a new mayhem, but a new dog.
Hold on. Let me write all this down.
Holy shit.
Whenever the season's about to wrap up, I usually find myself thinking, and when I get back, I'm going to call him. You know, casual, and just see how he's doing. I'll say something like, hey, I had a dream about you this summer and thought I'd call. You know, something that lets him know that I want him without letting him know I want him.
Okay, Delilah.
Yeah. Whatever you do, don't do that.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up.
Okay. Bye. You too, good luck.
You too. Good luck.
Why don't you keep that luck for yourself?
Oh, I see. Oh, there's the chopper. Holy shit, finally. Somebody. I can't believe it. Maybe we're gonna, like, trip down the stairs and die. I'm up here! Save me, you bastards! I need to get out of here! Lickety-split! That's right! I got novels to write about clowns and bears and everything else. Oh, this is pretty cool. Is that plane just, like, stuck in midair? It's nice. Alright, I made it. Is anyone in this helicopter? Can we see one person? Oh my god, it's an actual it's Ned. Watch it, it's Ned. Hello, I'm ready to go home now. Thank you, Ned. Please don't kill me on board the chopper. Oh my god. So many questions are going to be asked of me about what happened out here in the wilderness. Oh my god. Ugh, it's over. Wow! Holy shit! Oh, man! That was pretty cool, actually. It was pretty straightforward, though. I thought that there was going to be, like, a really big twist at the end. But it did actually have a lot to do with the Goodwins, it turns out. Which is pretty cool, actually. Oh, shit. Do we get to look at all my pictures now? Do you think? No? I mean, I took all of those pictures just in case. Oh yeah, look! It's all my pictures! Oh wow, I don't remember taking such great snaps. Look at all these cool snaps. Oh, we have to watch. You know why we have to watch? We have to watch the whole thing now because we want to see what those four pictures that, what's his face? Brian and his dad took. Because these are all the pictures I took, remember? Because I was paranoid that I was going to be arrested and convicted of killing two girls out in the wilderness that I did not do. So I was trying to get together a library of photographs to prove my innocence. But maybe I didn't need that after all. Did I take that picture? There's no way I did. Oh yeah, that's right. I did maybe accidentally take that picture. Here's the ravaged camp. There is my dick on the Hunks magazine. Oh yeah, there's my bed sheets with no stains on them. That was nice. Cool. And also the camp as I found it. It was untouched. I also took a picture of this big busted up stump. That was pretty good. Oh. Okay. I guess that's Ned. Or is that me? I'm not sure. This one is too blurry to see what it was. Oh, okay. That's Brian doing a joke with his dinosaur trying to attack the tower. And that, I guess, is Ned. And that is Brian. No, that's a bit of a sad story, actually, isn't it? There's Ned and Brian. So they were out there. I think Delilah blames Ned for killing Brian. And I guess you could actually say that Ned did kill Brian by, you know, pushing him into things that maybe he wasn't ready for, or ready to do, or whatever. It's difficult, I think, with kids, you know? If you have a kid, especially if you're a single parent, you take your kid out to do the things that you yourself are good at, but maybe your kid isn't, and you push them too hard. You know, it can end in tragedy, and then poor Ned is out there with that on his shoulders now. He'll never forget it, and he has to live rough for the rest of his life, because he can't really come to grips with what he caused and what happened, I guess. Man, pretty good story. Actually, all in all, together, that was fantastic. I really, really enjoyed that. I wouldn't even say I'm a sucker for these games. I just like the whole sort of, here's like a game, here's like 3-4 hours, it's an experience, you know, and you just get paranoid as you go on, thinking what's going to happen and stuff, and it's crazy. But it was very good. I highly recommend Firewatch. If you like these kind of games, you know, it's kind of like the beginner's guide. It's just one of those things that you have to experience, and it's really, really nice. And if you didn't watch me spoil the whole story for you, you can experience it for yourself, and it's very, very enjoyable. Excellent. Well, thank you very much for coming along on this journey with me. I enjoyed it thoroughly. It was really great. Sorry for all the spammy videos, but I want people to be able to watch this all the way through as soon as possible. So there's probably going to be like, or probably has been like 5 or 6 videos today on it or whatever. But it's worth it. Great. As usual, thanks very much for watching, and I will see you soon.